Very good morning to all the children of class 9th D as well as 9th A. So combined class today, we'll be continuing with paragraph writing. Fine. So I'll be giving a brief description again because 9th A has not done paragraph writing. नहीं किया बिल्कुल भी नहीं. So let me tell you what is a paragraph again. Paragraph is a series of sentences. Fine. Which are interconnected. Clear? So I won't be writing the definitions and all. I'll be straight away starting with features. So the children who have joined today or those who are sitting in the class, what is a paragraph? Paragraph is a series of sentences only. And they are interconnected to one another and they have just one theme. There are no multiple themes in paragraph. Is that clear to you? What is a paragraph? Now, talking about your term one syllabus, we have paragraph writing describing a person. And it can be a friend, it can be a teacher, it can be a mother, father, sibling, farmer, vendor, shopkeeper, maid, house help, anyone. Fine, whosoever you person meet you in your daily life, it can be anyone. Fine, so describing a person comes in that category. How we describe a person? Now the children who are present in the class, I'll be calling their names and they will tell me the features or value points. The very first line, yes, Pushti, stand up, tell me, what do we describe about a person? Firstly, yes, physical appearance. That how does that person look? Under the appearance, very good, Pushti has told us the first point. Can anyone tell me what was there under the this point? Yes, Divya has raised hand. Divya will tell me. Face shape, height, what else? Hair, nose, eyes. So we can describe about fine. So first is physical appearance. We talk about height, we talk about face shape, we talk about that the person has round face, oval shaped face, fine, long hair, short hair, cropped hair, pointed nose, button like nose, small nose ko button like nose bolte, fine, clear? And after that we can talk about facial expressions. Oh, Dhairya, what is the second point? Yes, after the appearance comes facial expressions. With this beta, it will be very helpful to you that how to write a paragraph. In facial expressions, what do we write?
I'm smiling.
Smiling, scornful, grumpy. Means some people have same expressions all the time. Some are very, we say he's very pleasing personality. You know, they just keep on smiling in everything. They talk to you in a very nice way. Some people are very rude. Their expressions are scornful. Gusse wale. Fine. In that way, we can talk about facial expressions. Fine. Smiling face. Scornful expression in that way. Clear? Example. So many words are there. We'll be using a few. Then next word. Yes, beta. Yes, very good. Sit down. Next is personality. Traits. What comes under personality? Soumya, you explain. Friendly. Moody. Gentle, kind, yes, talkative, fine in that way. So many points are there, fine, yes, introvert, extrovert, ambivert. We did many things today, I'm not able to, because yesterday we did in detail. That lecture is there on YouTube, you can see later. Fine, so personality traits, pleasing personality, the person is very kind, generous, fine. In that way, tell me more.
Polite.
Polite. jolly natured person, extrovert.
Fine.
New words we have done, extrovert, ambivert, introvert, fine. So anything you can write. Clear? After this, we have after personality, we can talk about habits, yes. Habits, the early riser, fine. Fitness freak. This is a habit. A person is into fitness, a person is into early rising, fine. So in that way, you can talk about habits. Some people have bad habits also, fine in that way, but you try to be positive. It depends upon which topic you have received. So after talking about habits, what else? Yes, we will be using this point to be kept in mind. Here I'm writing. Is there any Shivraj in your class? He's not written his class. So first thing is use adjectives, use similes to make comparisons. It's not smiles, it's similes. What else? Concluding remark that you'll be writing here. General traits you can talk about and then concluding remark. You can talk about the achievements of a person also. A core point likh lo. After habits, you can talk about general remarks or achievements of a person. If it's a, you're writing about a very famous personality, so then you can write about achievements also here. It depends that about whom you are writing. And then concluding remark. Last line should be very catchy and it should conclude everything about the person, that he is the wittiest person I know. He is the smartest person I know. Means we are just giving conclude that after telling all the traits, he is the smartest of all people I have, all persons I have met. That we have covered yesterday only. You were not there. You have written. Is it clear to all? Let's start with one paragraph now. Fine. I'm going to erase it. So we will be writing one passage. And the topic is my best friend. Very easy. I'm going to start from very easy one. Your topic of today is my best friend. Sare inhone revenge lene hai. Usko bald-headed kar dene. Fine. My best friend is bald-headed. And in that way, you'll be taking revenge on your friend. So try to write about any query is there. You can write in the chat box. Aparan of 9th. You can write here if you have a doubt. I won't be unmuting. I have never given right to the students. I don't know. Fine. You are writing. I have a doubt, but you are not writing what doubt you are having. See. That shows that what you want to do. So I'm not allowing you. Aparan is in your class.
Yes, sir.
The naughty kid. It's fine. So there are children sitting with me of other students of 9th. So I won't be giving chance to anyone to speak today because this is a combined class and I don't know the students. So I won't give a chance. Let's start. My best friend. So what you'll be doing in this, firstly, beta, you will be writing seriously about your best friend and you will talk about the physical appearance, then talk about facial expressions, personality, habits. So write down one passage with the help of you people. I'll be making you write only. So give the heading, my best friend, and write the name of that person. Suppose your friend, best friend name is Richard. So you're writing my best friend, Richard. So my best friend, jo bhi uska name hai, write down. Give the heading, everyone. We are going to write and you will be giving the lines to me. It's your choice. Don't write funny names. It's not funny enough, Brijesh. Why are n number of names are there? Come on, in your class, 46 students are there. You can write any name. My best friend dash. Jo bhi aapne apna name likhna friend ka, write down that. So I'm giving you hints for this. Firstly, you can tell that when do you become, you know, when did you become friends with that person? Is there any Mitansh in your class? So, John has been my friend since we were in primary school. Fine, or you can start writing with that also, general introduction, that topic sentence, that John has been my best friend since class nursery. Exact point of time you are giving here. So you can mention that, okay? Write down. John has been my best friend. Derek, you have not started writing. John has been my best friend since class nursery. Beta, this is same in every section, so kindly note down. Aapke ma'am ne bhi aise hi karwana tha. Secondly, after that, now come to physical appearance straight away. We don't have time enough to waste here and there. Mitansh, Patria, you can switch off your video. No need to switch it on. And you just keep noting down because it's creating distraction here. So, firstly, you will talk about his height, that he's tall and slim, fine? Fat or slim, whatever you want to write. He's tall and slim young man with curly dark hair and pointed nose. So I'm just telling you, from here you can use this appearance. You need not write about every face shape and hair and height and nose. You can pick up any two or three. Clear? So write down in that way. John has been my best friend since we were in class nursery. And now he's a tall and slim young man with curly dark hair, full stop. And now you, in next line, you will talk about he has bright sun-like face. I'm using adjective here, fine, because it's very bright face he has. He has bright sun-like, S-U-N, sun-like face. Now you'll talk about his attire also. Yes, one point I missed: after physical appearance and facial expressions, you can talk about attire. A-T-T-I-R-E. It means clothing. Fine. He always wears casual clothes. He always wears W-E-A-R-S, wears casual clothes. Now here you can, you know, you need not be very nice always. You can tell that in a very messy way, in a shabby way. Some children, they do not carry the clothes well. You know, they wear in a very shabby and messy way, they are dressed up. In my class also, I'm finding some children. So you can write in that way that he has brown small eyes with oval shaped face. Anything you can write. He has oval shaped face with button like nose. In that way you can write. Then after that you will tell about dress. He always wears casual clothes in a very messy way. M-E-S-S-Y, in a very messy way. Clear? Now you'll talk about personality. After telling about the attire, you'll talk about the, yes, personality. He's very outgoing in nature, or he's very extrovert, one and same thing. He's very outgoing in nature. Outgoing means he's very friendly with everyone. He does not hesitate while talking. Iska matlab ye. So he is an extrovert also, you can write. Chahe aise likh lo, ya he's outgoing in that. So he is an extrovert person who loves to have fun all the time. who loves to have fun all the time. So you're writing about your best friend. After this, you will tell me, I'll give you one more. So now you'll talk about his other traits. Fine, you can talk about other personality traits. You have talked about this. What else you can add up here? He has a great sense of humor. Yes, he's a multitasker, very good. And he keeps on, you know, he's always involved in many works at one time in that way. So he's right. Yes, he's good at sports. So many points are there. Well done, Brijesh. Then, beta, you can talk about that he's very, you know, he's got good sense of humor. And he always makes me laugh. And he always makes me laugh. Then you can talk about, but there is one shortcoming about his personality, that he is very short tempered. ठीक है, आपने पॉजिटिव बताया कि ह्यूमरस एंड ऑल दैट, बट ही इज वेरी शॉर्ट टेम्पर्ड. ही इजिली पिक्स फाइट्स विद अदर्स. ही इजिली पिक्स ऑन PICKS. He always picks on fights with others. Or fights ki jagah quarrels bhi likh sakte ho. Q-U-A-R-R-E-L-S. He easily picks up fights with others. He's a very good soccer player. He's a very good soccer player. Now I talk about his achievements. He has won many gold and silver medals in this very sport. This very sport mein aapne pehli line mein bol di hai soccer. This is very good soccer player. He has won many silver and gold medals in this very sport. S-P-O-R-T. And he also spends his weekends while getting training of soccer. He spends his weekends also in soccer training. Fine. After that, now you will be, Yes, he's very good at studies. You can talk about that. After that, beta, you can talk about habits. He's an early riser and always goes for walk with me. He's an early riser and always goes on walks with me. With his father or mother, you can write in that way also. Fine. After talking about habits, everybody likes him. Everybody likes him for his modesty. For his modesty and social skills. You know that the people who are very social, hum unke liye ek aur word use karte hain. Social butterfly. Social butterfly is a person who easily mixes up with others. Fine? Here doesn't suit. Fine? So we are coming to conclusion now. So we have talked about habits also. Huh. Then now we'll be talking about, we have talked about achievement, personality, attire, everything is covered. Now conclude it. Lastly, you can write, beta, like you'll be saying that I'm satisfied to have such friend like him. In that way, concluding remarks should be there. So everybody likes him for his modesty and social skills. And I never feel bored with him. I'm lucky to have a friend like John or like him. Fine. I'm lucky to have a friend like Richard. Jo bhi name aapne likha, I'm lucky to have. Yeah, I'm lucky to have him as my best friend. Yeah, I'm lucky to have him as my best friend. So this is a concluding remark. Similarly, if you, I'll be giving you examples. You can talk about your sister and brother. Then this is the same thing, yeah, that you'll be writing. Fine. So when you get why I have deliberately given this my best friend very easy topic, which even a class fifth student can do. Why? Yes, Param. Concentration should be here. Don't take the pen. First thing is that you'll talk about if you're talking about your brother, sister, same thing. If you're talking about your neighbor, same thing can be there. Fine. If you're talking about any other person, cousin, in that way. So this is very common thing where you will be able to write this. This is a very basic paragraph. Now, tricky it becomes when you will have to write about such personalities which are difficult to talk about. Like, let me give you 2-3 examples. Write down few examples. In your fear notebook, you will be writing this one, my best friend, and one more topic I'm giving you. Write a paragraph describing the personality of a street vendor who comes daily in your locality to sell vegetables. A vegetable seller, likh lo jaye. A street vendor, V-E-N-D-O-R, who comes daily in your locality to sell any object, you can say. I'm not giving specification of that he sells this thing only. So it is up to your imagination now. Who's a street vendor who comes to? Yes. Fine. It can be anything or any object which he is selling, a street vendor, whether it is vegetables or sometimes it is, you can, you know, write about the milkman. You can get the personality of a street beggar. Can you imagine what he will write in that? You can write about, you visited a mall, fine, and you bought some new dresses, write a paragraph about the personality of that person in that way. Clear? So you will be writing a street vendor. Now you tell me, let's first you give the answer, second boy, last boy. Yes, tell me how to start this. Firstly, we'll define a street vendor is a person who sells daily used objects by hawking in the streets. In that way also, street hawkers jo awaaz laga ke bechte hain. And in that way, by hawking in the street, H-A-W-K-I-N-G. And then this is the first line. What else you can write? Yes. Second girl, what else you can write? When so many brains at work, you will get ideas. He has given first line, you tell me about the second line. We'll be doing describing a persons only today. Yes, 10 minutes we have. Think about it now. See, it was very easy for us, na? So, yes. Fine. So, yeah, just directly come about your parents. Is it difficult enough that he's short in height, very bulky, fine, in that way, and always hawking loudly in the streets? Fine. Children love to, you know, gather around him as he's very, you can say, friendly with the children. Jolly natured personality. He keeps singing while selling the vegetables. He keeps singing loudly in melodious voice. Always smiling, fine. And Vegetables are fresh. Okay, Brijesh is saying vegetables are fresh. Then?
Kind and polite.
He's kind and polite. And people love to buy things from him as he's very friendly in nature. And when he does not come, when he does not enter our street, a void is felt. Void means khali panvi. Why a void is felt? Because his presence is quite noticeable. He's having noticeable presence. Some people, they come and go, we don't even realize. Clear? But some people have very, you know, they have presence to how to present themselves in front of other people. Yes, Peter. At very reasonable price. Yes. This is what you want to say, that when we bargain with him, he also gives things at very reasonable price. So that's why people loving to buy from him. Apart from this, anything you can add up from this thing. He's very punctual while visiting our street. This can be the habit. Exactly at 5 p.m. he enters our street, and everybody knows that at 5 p.m. you can talk about his name. Raghu Shyam is his name. Anything you can write. Yes. So you just give a point when we are going to end, and then you're talking about the physical appearance. So Brijesh, these things to be written. Firstly, to be avoided here. Yes, this is the question. 100 to 120 words. If yes, it is a short paragraph. Paragraph writing. If you're getting paragraph for 8 marks. Listen, children, if you are getting, you can decide then if you want to talk. I'm saying if it's a short writing skill for 4 marks or 5 marks, then it 100 to 120 words, like 7, 8, 8 to 10 lines. But when you're getting a paragraph for 8 marks, 9 marks, 10 marks, then obviously you have to stretch it to more than that, 150, 170 words. Fine? So it depends upon marking. Otherwise, it is a short writing skill only. But you should see the marking scheme accordingly. Any doubt to anyone regarding this? So write down some examples describing personality. Under just this is for your practice only, that you won't be writing in your fair notebook. Write down describing persons ke under likho. Street beggar. You think. Beta, this is the example only, that you should think about it, that if I get this topic, what should I write in that way? Street beggar, fine vendor, that we have already discussed, laborer, working nearby, suppose a house is being built up and laborers are working, mason, M-A-S-O-N, mason is the head of all the laborers. Yes, house maid or house help. Helper, house helper or house maid, M-A-I-D. Fine. My teacher. Then my mother. My father. Grandparents. Fine. So in that way. So Bella has gone, so I'll be ending the meet. Have a nice day, all of you.